an idea that Stubblefield's drawing shows would allow trains to communicate on railroad stations. Boats could talk to the White House.
What we know today is radio.
WNBS is the voice of Murray, Kentucky. WNBS could just be the birthplace of radio.
NBS, WNBS. Of course, so that's Nathan B. Stubblefield.
When I play my tambourine, it's all that I want and it's all that I need. Tambourine and a dancing girl, it's all that I want and it's all I need. Tambourine, four dancing girls, 20-piece band and a camera machine. We make music again and again and a television show for all our friends. A TV show and concerts too. We solve crimes while on the move. We film shots right on the spot, either at home or on Hollywood lot. Of the show, the audience clapping, we all know. One day, someday, very soon, you'll see this segment on a TV show. The lights are set and ready to go. The cameras are focused on the TV show. Everybody's moving to the beat of the band. And four dancing girls on my tambourine hand. We look to the left and we look to the right. We look for the camera's little red light. The actors are moving to and fro, 'cause the director just said, let's rock and roll.
The heroes of history are supposed to be the role models for the youth of today. My role models were Nathan B. Stubblefield and Mark Twain, the respective inventors of radio and Tom Sawyer. They knew the Mississippi River conveyancing, you know, how to communicate with the world. My new assignment? To browse the web to find a segment of one of my old shows to help me explain who invented radio. You know, when you want to send your message through space without wire. So I finally found one. Terry Bulger.
You know, if Nathan B. Stubblefield was your neighbor, he wouldn't have let you within 1,000 feet of his home. Nathan wasn't always so bitter towards people, but he became that way. Had good reason to. What made him so bitter? Photojournalist Brian Teal and I tuned into the radio to find out.
Just by listening to Jerry House tomorrow morning at 7:20. The phone's gonna start ringing and you're gonna win on Nashville's number one, WSIX.
We win. Both look real good, but 24 on the southeast, that's still a little bit slow between Haywood
Hello,
Lane
Pat,
and Bill.
WLAC.
Yeah, I don't know if I made a mistake or not.
Harry McLeod, Red Walker, the Zoo Crew, just proud, proud to be a part of this great industry we call radio.
It wakes us up in the morning, is a passenger in the car on the ride to work, helps hold our hand in the dentist chair. From sunup to sundown, radio is everywhere. It surrounds us so much that it's taken for granted. Hard to believe we can take for granted voices and music flying through the air without the help of wires. What may be even harder to believe is where it all began.
It's about 3.5 minutes away from 8 o'clock, the Drifters on WNBS.
WNBS is the voice of Murray, Kentucky. WNBS could just be the birthplace of radio.
NBS, WNBS. And, of course, that's Nathan B. Stubblefield.
Every radio station in the world today owes a debt to Nathan B. Stubblefield.
By 1887, at age 27, Stubblefield...
That is because in and around Murray State University, it is widely accepted and firmly believed that Stubblefield, a Murray, Kentucky melon farmer, invented the radio. It sounds like a folktale, but it's backed with solid proof. Born in 1860, Stubblefield's mind always drifted to science. He patented an invention that greatly improved the telephone, invented a lamplighter and electric batteries. But his obsession was this contraption. He called it the wireless telephone. We call it radio. An idea that Stubblefield's drawing showed would allow trains to communicate with railroad stations. Boats could talk to the lighthouse. Wires weren't necessary.
It was really what we know today as radio.
Murray State journalism professor Ray Mofield has been studying the Stubblefield story for 40 years.
He should have been a millionaire with his first public demonstration.
Former WNBS radio announcer Jim Johnson has studied it just as long. Both men believe the first radio broadcast ever happened on a deserted Murray Road in 1892 between Stubblefield and the man who founded Murray State University, Dr. Rainey T. Wells.